हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, नीताय गौरा हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल, नीताय गौरा हरि बोल, जय जय प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद, जय जय प्रभुपाद। हरे कृष्णा। थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर जॉइनिंग भगवत गीता क्लास टुडे। Today we are going to read verse number 22 from chapter 8. Okay, so I will recite one line and then you may repeat. Let me make it big so if it is small, we all can see nicely. Purusha sa paraha partha.
पुरुषा स परः पार्थ
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
येन सर्वं इदं ततम्
येन सर्वं इदं ततम्
पुरुषा स परः पार्थ
पुरुषा स परः पार्थ
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
येन सर्वम् इदं ततम्
येन सर्वम् इदं ततम्
पुरुषः स परः पार्थ
पुरुषः स परः पार्थ
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
येन सर्वम् इदं ततम्
येन सर्वम् इदं ततम्
एनीवन वुड लाइक टू रीड
पुरुषः स परः पार्थ
पुरुषः स परः पार्थ
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
येन सर्वम् इदं ततम्
येन सर्वम् इदं ततम् मनसि राधिका ओके पार्थ
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
भक्त्या लभ्यस्त्व अनन्यया
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
यस्यान्तः स्थानि भूतानि
येन सर्वमिदं ततां
येन सर्वमिदं ततां
ओके हरे कृष्णा सो नाउ वी विल रीड द सिनोनिम्स पुरुषः द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी
पुरुषः द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी
सः ही
सः ही
Paraha, the supreme, than whom no one is greater.
Paraha, the supreme, than whom no one is greater.
Partha, O son of Pritha.
Partha, O son of Pritha.
Bhaktya, by devotional service.
Bhaktya, by devotional service.
Labhyaha, can be achieved.
Labhyaha, can be achieved.
Tu, but. Ananyaya, unalloyed, undeviating.
Ananyaya, unalloyed, undeviating.
Yasya, whom. Antahastani, within. Bhutani, all of this material manifestation.
Bhutani, all of this material manifestation.
Yena, by whom. Sarvam, all. Idam, whatever we can see. Tatam is pervaded. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is greater than all, is attainable by unalloyed devotion. Although He is present in His abode, He is all-pervading, and everything is situated within Him. Purport. It is here clearly stated that the supreme destination, from which there is no return, is the abode of Krishna, the Supreme Person. The Brahma Samhita describes this supreme abode as Ananda Chinmaya Rasa, a place where everything is full of spiritual bliss. All the variegatedness manifest there is of the quality of spiritual bliss. Nothing there is material. That variegatedness is expanded as the spiritual expansion of the Supreme Godhead Himself. For the manifestation, there is totally of the spiritual energy, as explained in chapter 7. As far as this material world is concerned, although the Lord is always in His supreme abode, He is nonetheless all-pervading by His material energy. So, by His spiritual and material energies, He is present everywhere. Both in the material and in the spiritual universes. Yasyantah sthani means that everything is sustained within Him, within either His spiritual or material energy. The Lord is all pervading by these two energies. To enter Krishna's supreme abode or the innumerable Vaikuntha planets is possible only by bhakti, devotional service, as clearly indicated here by the word bhaktya. No other process can help one attain that supreme abode. The Vedas, Gopal Tapani, Upanishad 1.21, also describe the supreme abode and the supreme personality of Godhead. Eko Vashi Sarvagaha Krishnaha. In that abode, there is only one supreme personality of Godhead, whose name is Krishna. He is the supreme merciful deity. And although situated there as one, He has expanded Himself into millions and millions of planetary expansions. The Vedas compare the Lord to a tree standing still, yet bearing many varieties of fruits, flowers, and changing leaves. The planetary expansions of the Lord who preside over the Vaikuntha planets are four-armed, and they are known by a variety of names: Purushottam, Trivikram, Keshava, माधव अनिरुद्ध ऋषिकेश संकर्षण प्रद्युम्न श्रीधर वासुदेव दामोदर जनार्दन नारायण वामन पद्मनाभ एटसेट्रा. ब्रह्म संहिता 5.37 ऑल्सो कन्फर्म्स दैट ऑल्दो द लॉर्ड इज ऑलवेज इन द सुप्रीम अबोर्ड गोलोक गोलोक वृंदावन ही इज ऑल परवेडिंग सो दैट एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग ऑन नाइसली. गोलोक एव निवसत्य अखिलात्म भूतः एज स्टेटेड इन द वेदात श्वेताश्वतर उपनिषद 6.8 परस्य शक्तिर विविधैव श्रूयते स्वाभाविकी स्वाभाविकी ज्ञान बल क्रिया च. दीज एनर्जीज आर सो एक्सपेंसिव दैट दे सिस्टमैटिकली कंडक्ट एवरीथिंग इन द कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन विदाउट ए फ्लॉ ऑल्दो द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड इज फार फार अवे. ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीनिति नामिने. नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यादेशतारिणी श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवास आदि गौर भक्तरुंद. हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा. थैंक यू अगेन फॉर एवरीवन हु जॉइन द क्लास टुडे. दिस इज वर्स 22 फ्रॉम चैप्टर 8. सो बिफोर वी सी दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्स मे बी इट वुड बी वर्थ वाइल जस्ट टू रिकैप what Bhagavan Krishna is explaining to Arjun at this stage. So this all the way goes to the verse 14 in this chapter 8. So this as we know this chapter 8, the title of the chapter says Attaining the Supreme, where Bhagavan Krishna declare how to attain him or his abode. Abode is nothing but the place where he is residing. So what I'm showing on the screen is like a quick recap. As I said, from 14, where in the 14 text, if you read it out, where Bhagavan Krishna says how to attain him, and where Bhagavan Krishna says to Arjun, for one who always remembers me, always remembering. Without deviation, I am easy to obtain. O son of Partha, Prutha. O son of Prutha. Prutha is the another name of Kunti Dev. Because of his constant engagement in devotional service. So here Bhagavan Krishna declares how one can obtain him easily. So obtaining means it's not like physically grabbing. Obtaining means how, that also Bhagavan Krishna declares. That's the last part. Bhakti, devotional service, that is serving the God, ahaituki, when there is no intention. So that's how we obtain the God. So it's not like something like in our material world, when we say, I'm going to obtain, say, anything in our life. So that has some material form, material connotation, right? And then we have some selfish objective, in our material world. But however, obtaining Krishna is nothing but surrendering and serving Krishna. That is the devotional service, ahaituki. Now after 14, all the way from text 15, all the way up to this current verse. Right? Now Bhagavan Krishna, this all these verses, so what they talk about is there is an emphasis on how to fixing the mind on Krishna, right? So that's where in the verse Bhagavan Krishna saying, so you fix your mind on me, constant remembering. And then in the subsequent verses, now they talk about how one get a trigger to fix mind on Krishna. What needs to happen? So in essence or in gist, if one start contemplating how everything else in this material world is temporary, and if I fix my mind, or if I work hard, if I strive hard for that, those temporary things, ultimately it will end up into misery. So in this 4 to 5 verses, even Bhagavan Krishna gives some references to the Brahma as well. So even Brahma's abode or the residing place is also a temporary in nature. So these verses basically help us to start contemplating on how everything else around us is temporary. And whatever emotions that we get, let's say when we acquire something, when we lose something, immediate reaction is emotions. Either happiness or sadness, and sometimes fear. There are so many emotions. Now, once we start contemplating those all things around us are temporary, and eventually they end up into misery. So now, what Bhagavan Krishna saying is, fix mind on me. What is fixing mind meaning? Surrender to Krishna and starts and serve the Krishna. Okay. So, and then this particular verse that we see here, if you see here today's verse, where Bhagavan Krishna says that the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is greater than all, is attainable by. So again here, if you see Bhagavan Krishna saying how attainable, but how? Again, so Bhagavan Krishna is actually insisting on this particular aspect, devotion, unalloyed, undeviating, and ahaituki. So, so the Supreme Personality, so in the translation, it is clearly states that Krishna, who is greater than all. So now all means not just material, not just living beings like us, definitely is greater than us in all respects, all the qualities, but anyone, it could be demigods as well. So he is greater in all various qualities. And how we can attain is unalloyed devotion. Right? So now the next line is also very important. But Bhagavan Krishna says, although he is present in his abode, he's all pervading. Mm-hmm. Now, this is something sometimes it confuses us. Krishna is residing in his house, abode meaning the place where he is residing. And here it also says he's all pervading, means he's also here in all material worlds. Even in our, say, in this particular whole nature that we have around us, We see mountains, rivers, oceans. We see a forest. This society, the civilization. Then the question is, how it is possible when Krishna is residing in somewhere far, and how Krishna is saying, "I am here also."
I didn't know which.
Yeah,
it was a. So here it says everything is situated within him.
And then the crowns, everything you can
hear your mother come to
the box. So we can match any crown that we come now.
Yeah, except there's one that's within.
Oh, some microphone.
Jiva and Maltipriya, you're talking with an open mic.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
No problem. Hare Krishna. Okay. Okay. So it is the inconceivable feature that we were just talking about, where Krishna is residing somewhere else. Somewhere else means is his own abode, Krishna Loka. And he's also pervading. Pervading means he also is present. And here it says everything is also situated within him. And this is inconceivable. I know we are reading it, we are hearing it from senior Vaishnavas, but we are not experiencing this. Right? So then confusion, question may come in our heart. But I think that's where the faith play a more important role, and that faith and that I would say the conviction grows more and more as we hear more and more from senior Vaishnava and our spiritual master. So one example. Chaitanya Charan Prabhuji, I was reading his article about this particular verse. He gave a very nice example. So he's connecting this to our day-to-day life. When we do a practice, when we do a sadhana. So his point was that in our life, when we are strive for something challenging, then our attitude is very important. Something is challenging, we want to achieve. We know that is something very difficult. So then our attitude is either we continue or we quit. Right? In our real life also, if we are trying to achieve anything, whether we want to achieve, say, a job, or maybe in business, I want to achieve some deal, business deal, or even in day-to-day life, it could be as small as thing, it could be as big as, it doesn't matter. In the life, those things keep coming on our path, and some things are very challenging. Sometimes it takes a lot of effort. That's where the attitude matters, like how I see it, and how then I plan for it, put effort and try to achieve it. Now the attitude is, if that become too, if on the path, somewhere I feel, I think this is not my cup of tea. And then slowly I start quitting. So depending on the attitude, like how that person keep his attitude, and same is applicable when he's doing the spiritual sadhana. So now attitude here with respect to this verse, Krishna is somewhere in the remote. Now that remoteness of Krishna, or just the thought that this whole Krishna's abode is somewhere very, very far, I can't even see. I can't even imagine, that's beyond my imagination. It's so far. That shouldn't become a reason for us to, you know, get demotivated in our sadhana. Because as we are practitioner, sometimes our sadhana is fluctuating. But depending, and that sometimes faith is also continuously kind of sometimes fluctuates. That's why it is very important that how do we keep our faith and sadhana consistent. That's where and devotee association play a huge role. Sometimes we alone may try, and but if we are not strong enough, sometimes we may lose our sadhana, our faith may fluctuate. That's why it's very important, like at least I can talk about me, that the practitioner always stay in the association of devotee. That association will keep pushing forward and not backward. So Bhagavad Gita states, beyond this material world, there exists a spiritual world. Now Bhagavad Gita also gives that knowledge to us. If we just say that spiritual world is far, far away, I'm just hearing, I don't know where it is. I don't know how to go there, right? By material means. But Bhagavad Gita gives that knowledge, that spiritual, how the material worlds are, their temporary nature, where the spiritual world is, right? So that knowledge, Bhagavad Gita talk about different verses, like verse number 8.20, verse number 8.21. So whenever we, as we are doing sadhana, and when we feel discouraged, thinking that we are so far away from Krishna's abode, one important and very good news is that we should think that Krishna is always with us. Even though his abode is far, I know Krishna's abode and Krishna, they are same, they are not different, but we need to remember that Krishna is also always with us. And that's where, so he is present in our own hearts. And we know how that is possible, right? We have heard this many, many times. So he manifests in everyone's heart in the form of super soul. So we don't have to get discouraged that Krishna is living so far, far away and there is no way, and my sadhana is not strong enough and that I cannot go to his abode, right? So that's why this bhakti yoga, there are no other, I would say, no other solutions, no other ways in material world like supersonic jet or maybe rocket that we can plan and go to Krishna's abode. No. This is totally different, on a different plane. It's not about on the material plane. So that's why in this verse also, Krishna talks about devotion. So more we practice devotion, the more we appreciate his proximity and mercy. If we don't practice more and more, even though he is present, we are not feeling that he's next to us. That is the beauty of the devotional service. As we start practicing more and more devotional service, ahaituki. Initially, it may not be ahaituki, but I think we should continue our devotional service in whichever form we can, in whichever state where we are. We may be young, we may be small, we may be middle-aged, we may be aged, like we have some diseases, but we should continue our devotional service, because that will help us feeling that proximity with Krishna. And this is not something imagination. Srila Prabhupada and Acharyas, and this, the Acharya in all disciplic succession, they have followed this path. It's not like just imagination and something that, oh, we will feel Krishna is next to us. So once we start performing devotional service, that then Krishna's mercy, by his mercy, we will start experiencing the proximity with Krishna. So until now, Krishna has guided us in many lifetimes, right? Now, even today, at least the devotees who are on this call, all the practitioners on this call, right? We have come through many lifetimes, right? But what we can see here, in this life also, each one of us is practicing devotion. It is really worth to pat our back. Yeah, if no one else, then we can pat our back ourselves. So Krishna has guided us even until this lifetime, and we have a desire, all of us, that even attending this lecture is one form of devotional service, hearing, right? So that is where we should be very grateful to Krishna, how he is reciprocating. So he's continuously helping us, regardless of our inconsistency, regardless of our half-heartedness, regardless of many offenses. He's still keeping, he's still coming, reciprocating, so that we still have that desire, maybe small, maybe big, maybe medium, but some desire that I should continue my devotional service. Right? So, going back to this particular verse, this particular explanation is how the devotional service is so important, and even Bhagavan Krishna is actually giving tremendous importance to the devotional service. And the second line in this translation, it talks about inconceivable feature of Krishna. That is, everything is in the Krishna and Krishna is in everything. In short, that second line means. So everything is in Krishna and Krishna is in, it sounds confusing. I'm going to share some examples. Even it may, our mind may accept theoretically, but we haven't experienced it. But we have to trust what Acharyas have explained, Srila Prabhupada has explained. So everything is in Krishna. There is a nice example, like Mahavishnu. This is explained in Bhagavatam too. That is whole creation process of universes, the entire many, many universes, the entire matter, living being, very in detail it is explained. Okay. So God, meaning the Supreme Personality, exists in multiple manifestation at multiple levels. So one of the manifestation is Mahavishnu. And Mahavishnu is a form from whom the universe emanates. This form demonstrates how all of existence is inside him. Right? So this is one example of how everything is in Krishna. And second is, Krishna is in everything. So this is explained in Srila Prabhupada lecture too, that Krishna is present in the heart of every living being. It's not just humans, animals, birds, any species, small, big, micro, that's something we only see under microscope. Any living being, that Krishna is in their hearts. From even invisible atom to immeasurable universe. So that's how Krishna is in everything. So that's where Bhagavan Krishna is explaining in this particular translation also, that he is all pervading and everything is situated within him. And in this particular purport, Srila Prabhupada talk about in the second purport, second paragraph, to enter Krishna's supreme abode or the innumerable Vaikuntha planets is possible only by bhakti. No other process can help one attain that supreme abode. Now, what is the takeaway for us? Of course, this is the ultimate, that is the goal for a devotee that we all are striving for. Because if I or we don't do this, we will be back into repeated cycle of birth and death. So we know why we are doing. That is one. That is getting out of the repeated cycle. And second, to get the love of Krishna. So Bhagavad Srila Prabhupada said there is no other process possible. No other process. Only bhakti yoga. Only devotional service. That's the only process that can get us there. And then there is a reference from Gopala Tapani Upanishad where it says, Eko Vashi Sarvagaha Krishnaha. Sarvagaha means all pervading. Sarva, everywhere. Sarvagaha Krishna. So Sarvagaha means all pervading. So there is a reference from Upanishad too. Now Srila Prabhupada give a reference from Vedas. That Vedas compare the Lord to a tree standing, yet bearing many varieties of fruits, flowers, and changing leaves. And the plenary expansions of the Lord who preside over Vaikuntha planets are forearmed with the different forms that we have learned about it in many, many, you know, lectures, books, especially Bhagavatam, Purushottam, Trivikram, Keshava, Madhava, Aniruddha. So here, these are different characteristics. So here, what we try to understand, so Bhagavan Krishna is absolute and he's pervading everywhere. That's why Srila Prabhupada is explaining us how to understand this. How he is present in his multiple forms. These are different forms. That's what it says. These are plenary expansions of the Lord. So if I go to this line that Bhagavan is saying, right? He's all pervading. How do I understand this? Right? So that's why Srila Prabhupada is giving various references so that we can understand this better. And finally, the Brahma Samhita. So Brahma Samhita confirm, although Lord is always in supreme abode, that is Golok Vrindavan, he is all pervading. So that everything is going on nicely. This is another reference from Brahma Samhita. Now this particular purport and verse, of course, it is a knowledge for us. How Bhagavan Krishna, Supreme Personality, and how you, with his multiple form, he is pervading everywhere. Of course, it emotion is like a awe and reverence, right? How big and how he's managing so much, right? But more important, especially for us, is how do I attain? And that's where that connects to our day-to-day life. And we have heard this many, many times, like Srila Prabhupada has given us those do's and don'ts. That is four regulative principle and chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. That is for us. It could be, so I mean, during this journey, we may get many hiccups, but if we continue with devotee association, I think even though there are hiccups, devotee association will give us enough strength to move forward. Enough strength to move forward. So the devotional service is not imagination, is real, and that we have to do very sincerely. That includes chanting. That is, we should try to do attentive chanting as much as possible. And in one of the lecture, in that lecture, speaker was explaining, the question was like, how do we be attentive? Because that's devotional service. Even Srila Prabhupada insisted heavily that do chanting, more and more chanting. So how do I do attentive chanting? So one, and I like this tip. The tip is, instead of asking our mind to be attentive for 16 round, we can start with, okay, let's be attentive on one round. That if even that also doesn't help, then at least ask our mind the next one Maha Mantra that I'm going to say, that is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. At least for these 16 words, let me concentrate myself only on the 16 words. And once, and let's see, if mind accepts that concentration and listen all those 16 words, then it's a success. And for next 16 words, again say the same to the mind. Oh, okay. I may not need the concentration for everything, but at least for next another 16 words, please, I want this concentration. So this is basically you are praying to Lord, I need concentration so I can focus on next 16 words in the mantra. Having this practice, it helps some devotees to build attentiveness. Of course, that is one. And second is definitely try to do this chanting during the early morning. Amrendra Prabhuji, he's another speaker in ISKCON. In his lecture, he always mentioned that we must, he used word must do chanting in the morning hours. Because as the day progress, then lots of things keep hitting our mind and then it is difficult to do concentration. So it is always that we should do chanting. So that's what it says. So this attainable, so going back to the verse, if we continue with this practice, devotion, chanting, serving now, serving Krishna is nothing but serving devotees. And serving devotees could be of any form. We can serve devotees, like if they are in a difficult situation, if they need any help, that level of help, even some devotees facing some challenges in the life, how we can help them, or we can bring senior Vaishnava to guide them in the right way. So there are many ways we can serve devotees. It could be in terms of preaching or actual physical help, so and so forth. So this particular verse, again, the translation says, Supreme Personality of Godhead is attainable by unalloyed devotion. And the second line says about the characteristics of the Bhagwan. He is even though he's residing in his place, Golok Vrindavan, is all pervading here. So if someone says, where is Krishna? I'm saying in general. You are in ISKCON, you are doing Krishna, so where is Krishna? interestingly, Radhika got that question from her neighbor. Where is Krishna? So Radhika spontaneously said, Krishna is everywhere. And it's interesting. So I think that's pretty much, I think, the gist. Krishna is everywhere. He is all pervading. With that said, I would like to stop here with these two takeaways. One is devotional service. That is the only way to attain. And second is characteristics of the Lord. That is who is pervading everywhere, even though his sweet home is in the Golok Vrindavan. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much for attending today. If you have any comments, questions, please share.
Very nice, Madhav Kanta Prabhu. Such a nice explanation of Krishna's abode and his energies.
Thank you, Madhav.
Almost makes us feel how are we going to get there, but you were talking about the morning hours. It is always good to finish all of the chanting in the morning hours, you know, but a lot of times some of us who are I do try to get up in the morning, but I feel so sleepy all the time that my chanting is not so good in the morning, even if I'm doing it, you know. So even when I'm doing it in the evening, I'm much more awake. So isn't that sometimes a little better that you're chanting with more concentration than chanting with a little bit of sleepiness in the morning.
I would say that if you get concentration in the evening, mm-hmm. I think that's much better, because the whole concept of morning is, because morning mind is fresh and high chances of concentration. That's why the morning, I that's my understanding, why this Brahma Muhurta and this morning becomes so important. But for you, if evening your concentration is high, I think that
really
matters.
Yeah, I'm not saying all of my rounds, but some of my rounds, you know, I finish.
That matters. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I tried that tip, that rather than focusing on all 16, just focus on 16 words. It sometimes helps me at least.
That is a very good point. Like I remember Jiva saying one time that even one round, if he sincerely surrendered, even not one round, one mantra.
Yeah.
You know, if he sincerely surrender, even one mantra makes a difference, you know. That is something we all really should very, very, very much aspire to do. That, you know, even in that one mantra, if you're completely sincerely surrendering and thinking of Krishna,
yeah,
it is to our great benefit, you know. And that is something everyone can aspire to do.
Yeah. And that works. But again, as more and more sometime, but at least we should try as much as possible, I would say. Yeah.
Yeah. But it's so nice that, you know, I'm also reading the Bhagavatam where I think it's third canto, part one, which describes the spiritual kingdom of God, you know, and you also were explaining Goloka eva nivasatya kilatva bhuta, you know, from Brahma Samhita today. Even a little bit of explanation of the spiritual world sounds so wonderful, you know, where there is no anxiety, there is all opulence, you know, the kalpavraksha trees, even I think yesterday.
Is that a tree? Yes.
Yeah, Srinivasacharya.
Surabhi cow.
Surabhi cows. Stuff. So lecture after lecture I'm hearing about the kingdom of God lately. and I remember Srila Prabhupada also saying that Vrindavan is village life. It is like, you know, it's not like city life and city opulence. It is not, you know, as Vaishnava devotees we don't even aspire to go to Dwarakadham, you know what I'm saying, which is kind of a different kind of opulence, right?
Yeah.
Whereas Srila Prabhupada says that Vrindavan is village life, but it's not like poverty-stricken village life. It is like, you know, supremely opulent village life, you know, when nothing is, you know, the rivers are flowing, everything is, the grains are growing, you know, Surabhi cows and, you know, Chintamani trees that give you everything.
Chintamani,
you desire.
Yeah.
But the focus is Krishna's service, you know, everything to please Krishna.
Correct. And it's entirely opposite here. We all always run behind the opulence. Oh.
Right. But I don't forget where Srila Prabhupada says that. I don't know whether I read it in the Bhagavatam or in one of the Bhagavad Gita verses yesterday or day before yesterday. Srila Prabhupada said, I think it was in the Bhagavad Gita, one of the verses, that it is a bitter struggle for existence in this material world. You know, even if we are making some money, even if we're getting some opulence, I think those are the exact words he used, the bitter struggle for existence, you know, in this material world. So it seems like futile, you know, to want to gain anything here or stay for here for anything.
True, Mataji.
Because even if you are wealthy, even if you get or relatively wealthy, you know, it is nothing compared to the, you know, without Kunta, with no anxiety, opulence of the spiritual world, you know, with Krishna in the center and you know, Sachidananda, you know, life.
Yeah,
yeah. Here it is like no matter what you get, it is a bitter struggle for existence, you know, and don't we feel it?
True.
Whether it's the job or, you know, some problem or some
anything.
Family issue, yeah.
Relationship, everything.
Relationship, something or the other constantly hounding us. Yeah.
Yeah. Health and all. Everything.
Yeah, health. Yeah. And finally, you know, death.
Death. Movie's over.
Movie's over. That's what you have to look forward to. Whereas in spiritual world, there is no anxiety of birth, death, old age, or disease. And there's only bliss, you know. And it seems like, why don't we get it? You know, why can't we? Like, what did you say today? Ahetuki pratihata, right? Mm. It is that unmotivated, unalloyed devotional service. That yes. doesn't seem to come so easily.
Not easily, Mataji. Looks like sometimes I feel myself, my mind is trying to get put legs on both the boats. One boat is going here, another boat is going there. I'm not taking my foot off that other boat,
right?
Anyway, going to sink.
Yeah, we still have that hope that we'll find some pleasure there. That everything will be perfect somehow in this material world, you know. And this mind is like, what did you say? Yesterday I was reading, is faster than the wind, you know, to control. And only way we can control is by chanting the holy name, by concentrating on Krishna's lotus field, feet.
Yeah, true. And devotee association.
Mm-hmm.
I was hearing Giriraj Maharaj lecture maybe 2-3 days back. He mentioned like very brief and nicely, precisely, like one should start. We always hear in Bhagavad Gita or maybe other shastras that one should detach. And we should do the detachment. Giriraj Maharaj said, instead of doing detachment, we should rather cultivate attachment.
Attachment. Right?
I like this. The way he articulated.
Our process. Our process is not, what is that?
Our process is not about detachment. It's about attachment.
Avaroha Pantha and that, what is that other two? Aroha and Avaroha Pantha or something, you know. Descending mercy and or ascending. Process.
Oh, that is, ours is from Bhagavatam,
Mataji. Yeah, there is that ascending process and the descending process, you know, Aroha Pantha and Avaroha Pantha, I think it's called.
Okay.
So I think we follow the descending mercy process, you know, not try to ascend ourselves.
Yeah.
And then, yesterday, the mind is restless, turbulent, obstinate, and very strong. O Krishna, to subdue it, I think, is more difficult than controlling the wind. And in the purport, the last line, Srila Prabhupada says, the method prescribed to control the mind is Savai Mana Krishna Padarimandayo. One must engage one's mind fully in Krishna. Only then will there remain no engagements to agitate the mind. Yeah. But the qualification is fully engage one's mind in Krishna. Krishna's lotus feet. Samai mana Krishna pada aravindayo.
Right, right. Nice, Mataji. Thank you for sharing.
And even Arjuna says, mind is faster. If Arjuna has to say that, what hope there is for us. Yeah.
Oh, we don't have that our other Prabhuji on the line, because he asked me that question last time, even 2 weeks
Kwaku
back.
Oh, Prabhu, he asked very good questions today.
He said, what is Ashtavakra Gita? So I wanted to share something, but I think he's not here.
Yeah, I think Ganapati Govind answered some of it, that he didn't hear anything much about it from bona fide paths, you know, about that. Okay.
Also, Ganapati Govind already told them is good.
Yeah, nice. He mentioned, yeah.
Okay, good.
But he said he has vaguely heard about it, but not any of the bona fide scriptures.
Right. There is something on Google, lots of, but sometimes Google not always authentic. So
yeah, and Ganapati Govind said he hasn't found it anywhere in any of the bona fide scriptures.
Yeah, yeah. That's correct. Maybe next time when he joined, we can. If you still want to know something, maybe we'll see if he has any specific questions.
Yeah, he asked some very sincere questions, and he's making a lot of progress. He remembers things and he answers the questions well. Yesterday, Srinivas Acharya was giving a class, and he knew a lot of the. He was answering, as Srinivas Acharya was asking questions, he was answering them really well.
Nice. Hare Krishna.
I know. See, if you're sincere, you can make progress so fast. Huh?
Okay, I think we are almost 8 o'clock. I think we are exact 8 o'clock.
Sorry, so, I didn't mean to hog all the time. If anybody has any other questions.
Anyone has any questions, comments? Okay, if not, we'll stop here. Vancha kalpa tarubhyascha kripa sindubhya evacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha ananta koti vaishnavrundaki
shila
pila prabhat ki jai bhagavad gita ki
jai
madhav kanta prabhu ki
jai
radhika little radhika ki jai
gita mala mataji ki jai
krishna hare krishna Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Ki jai.